Halo, assalamualaikum. Welcome to my channel, Widodo from Department of Mathematics, Gajah Mada University, Indonesia. Today we want to continue our discussion the application of definite integral for surface area of solid revolution. We want to discuss about three things. The surface area of solid revolution in Cartesian coordinate, and then for parametric equation, and also the polar coordinate. As I told you in the previous section, that these are example of the solid revolution in daily life. The main problem of our solid, of our surface area of solid revolution is the following. Suppose we have the arc K defined by the x, y, the x between A and B, the y is equal to fx, just like this. This is the K. If we rotate the key one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have the surface, and we want to find the area of the surface, the area of the surface in three cases. The first is in Cartesian coordinate, in parametric equation, and in polar coordinate. Briefly, actually, we have the following formula. For the Cartesian coordinate, these two formula. The first is that the surface area of the coordinate of the Cartesian coordinate case is just this formula, 2phi integral AB y the square of 1 plus dy dx square dx. This is the rotation with respect to x-axis, and in the case of the rotation with respect to y, the formula is like this. Yeah. And thirdly is the surface area of the solid revolution in the parametric case, parametric equation case, with respect to the x-axis is just this equation, with respect to y is just this equation, and the fourth is the formula for the surface area of solid revolution in polar coordinate. So we have actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have actually 6 formula. Here we want to follow the book of Sullivan by using the following way. First we want to prove in the case of 3, in the case of parametric equation, and then the case of Cartesian coordinate, and then go to the final one, the case of polar coordinate. We will start from the first one, that is parametric equation. So I take this lecture from the book of Sullivan and Miranda. So first we want to prove the formula of surface area of solid revolution for parametric equation. And secondly, just by using the first formula, and then we derive the second formula as a special case, and then thirdly is for polar coordinate. Let us start for the formula of surface area for the parametric equation. Here the formula is actually based on the area of frustum. If we have a frustum, you see here the frustum. Actually, the frustum is just coming from this area. Line. This line, the blue one, the blue line. If the blue line is rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have the frustum. And as you know here that the area of the frustum is actually the 2phi, the 2phi times r1 plus r2 divided by 2 times l. L is the length of this curve. And we see here the r1 plus r2 divided by 2 is actually the average of the radius. The radius, the big radius here and the small radius here, we take just here the average. So remember, this is the base formula for finding the formula of surface area, yeah, by using the area of frustum. That is the 2phi times the average of the radius and times the length, L. In general, of course, we don't have this because this is very special. In general, we have like this. If the curve given in a parametric equation, we can imagine like this. And if the curve C, the blue one, is rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have a shape. And the shape has area called surface area. How can we can find the formula? Just by using the definition of definite integral, we can make a partition. So we have to make a partition. As you saw, the t0 is equal to a, t1, t2, t3, ti minus 1, ti, tn minus 1, and the p itself is equal to tn. We can, as usual, we can choose the easy one, that the delta t is equal, r equal, the p minus a divided by n. Corresponding to the partition a, t1, t0 until tn, of course, we have a point. Point p0, p1, and so on, pi minus 1, pi, pn minus 1, pn, on the curve of C. And then we can take every 2 points, for instance, from p0 to p1, we have to take these 2 distances, pi minus 1 and pi, we take these the distance of these 2 points, the distance of the 2 points. So if we take the p0 like this, p0, of course p0, what is p0? P0 is actually T0 x T0 comma y T0, that is P0. P1 is actually x T1 comma y T1, and so on. So we have here actually P0. P0 is a point x T0, y P0, and so on. In general, we have pi minus 1, pi. The pi minus 1 is actually the point with coordinate x ti minus 1, y ti minus 1. And pi is actually the point with coordinate x ti, y ti. And we have here the red one. The red one is straight line between pi minus 1 NPI, we want to use the red one to approach the blue one. Actually, the real thing that we want to count is the blue one, but we can approach by using PI minus 1 PI. If we rotate the segment or the line PI minus 1 PI, yeah, we rotate one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have something like this, this shape. What is this? This is actually the frustum. This is actually the frustum, exactly the same as the frustum here, exactly the same. And what is the area of the frustum? The area of the frustum is, according to the formula of the frustum, this is equal to SI to phi, and then times the average of this as the radius, and time the distance between PI minus 1 and PI. And the distance is just usual distance. We want to write it down later on. So actually, the shape of the blue one rotated one round with respect to x-axis is approached by using this frustum shape. So we want to calculate the frustum area SI, because the distance between PI, D is the distance actually, between PI minus 1 PI is the root square of the XTI minus XTI minus 1 square plus YTI minus YTI minus 1 square. And by using mean value theorems, we have that there exists a UE here in such a way that the derivative of x with respect to t in the point UI time delta I is equal to this difference. This is the mean value theorem from calculus 1. By the same way, by the same reason, we also have the YTI minus VTI minus 1 is equal to a certain point here, the derivative, the derivative, the for a certain point VI delta I. Okay, so this is the mean value theorem. And then we substitute the XTI minus 1 to here, and VTI minus VTI minus 1 to here. So altogether we have the distance between PI minus 1 and PI. I'm sorry. Okay, just by using this substitution, then we have that the distance between PI minus 1 and PI, yeah, just like this, yeah, just by substitution and easy calculation. And finally, we have that the distance is just like this, yeah, because the delta T square taking for the root become delta T itself. So this is the delta T. So altogether, if we sum up for the n frustum, because we have here, we have n frustum, because here we have the n something like this, so n frustum, because the area of the frustum is SI. So we sum up the sigma SI is a from 1 until n. This is the sum of the whole frustum. Then we have this one. Okay. And then we are ready to take the limits. We are ready to take the limit. If we take this sum, take the limit for this sum, the norm tend to 0 or n tend to infinite, then we have the integral. Then by using the definite integral, then we have the integral the integral of 2 phi y times the square of the dx dt square dy dt square delta dt, just like this. So we have the formula of the area of the solid revolution for the parametric equation is just s equal to 2 phi integral ab y t square root of dx dt square plus dy dt square dt. So this is the proof of the formula. So we already have one formula for the surface area of solid revolution for parametric equation, just like this. Okay, this is the first formula. We will go to our example. For example, if we have the parametric function x t is equal to 2 times t power 3 and y t is 3 t squared between t between 0 and 1, the curve look like this. This t score curve from 0 until 1. If we rotate one round this curve c surrounding the x-axis, then we have the solid revolution like this. And what is the area, the surface area of this solid revolution? Of course, we have the s is equal to 2 phi integral from 0 until 1, from 0 until 1, because we want to count from 0 until 1, from 0 until 1, from 0 until 1. The y is equal to 3t square, and then the square root of the dx dt is actually equal to 60 square. This is 60 square, and dy dt is equal to 60. So it is 60 square. So the s is just like this, and then by using the definite integral, we can calculate this easily. We will see here. The calculation is just like this. Yeah. The 2 phi integral 0 until 1 of this number. This number is just the same as this number, okay? And then by using easy calculation, I don't want to go in detail because it is only definite integral calculation. So 2 phi integral 0 1 of this one. And by using substitution, that the u is equal to t square plus 1, then we have the integral from 0 until 1 become from 1 to 2, because when the t is equal to 1, u is equal to 1. When the t is 0, then u is equal to 1. When the t is equal to 1, the u is equal to 2. So this become this. The restriction with respect to the integral u is 1, 2. Yeah. We can easily calculate this one. We can have the result. The result is equal to 24 phi divided by 5 times the square of 2 plus 1, a square unit. We do not need to calculate by using this number, I think. Just this number is enough. So this is the first example, okay? Hopefully it is clear. Of course, as I told you that the previous formula is for rotating with respect to x-axis. If we rotate the arc or the curve with respect to y, then the formula is s equal to 2 phi integral ab x t the square root of dx dt square plus dy dt square. If we in the previous formula, the x is y t here because it is with respect to y, then we have this one. Okay. This is the example for the formula of surface area of solid revolution in Cartesian coordinate rotated about x-axis. Okay. In the second case, we want to find the formula of area of solid revolution obtained from the Cartesian coordinate. As we see in the first calculus or calculus 1, we see that the explicit formula y is equal to fa, where the x between a and b is actually special case of the parametric equation where the xt is equal to t. This is the identity function. The xt is equal to t. So that we can derive the formula here. We can derive this formula, the 2 phi integral ab yt, the square root of dx dt square plus dy dt square. We take the special case, and then from this formula, we have the formula of surface area for explicit function in Cartesian coordinate. Okay, how can we do that? We can do the following. First, we assume we know that from calculus 1 that the explicit function y is equal to f x between a and b is a special case of the parametric equation where the xt is equal to t, so that we can write that the yt is equal to ft, and then it implies that the dx dt is equal to 1 because x is equal to t, identity function. And of course, by using this equation, the dx is equal to dt, and the dy dt is equal to the dy dt, dy dx, dx dt, because the dx dt is equal to 1, so it is equal to dy dt. So it is actually dy dt is equal to the f prime t. That is the derivative of the explicit solution. By using this, then we can substitute this result to the previous result, that is the s is equal to 2 phi, the integral from a b y t, the square root of the dx dt square plus dy dt square dt. But here the dx dt is equal to 1, because the dx dt is equal to 1 because xt is equal to t, so dx dt is equal to 1. So this is actually replaced by 1, and this is still dy dt is still exists here. So all together we have that the yt is actually the yt is equal to ft, the yt is equal to ft here, yeah. So all together we have that yt replaced by fx. So s is equal to 2 times phi, the integral from a to b ft, the square root of 1 plus f prime x square dx. So this is actually the formula of surface area of solid revolution in the explicit function like this in Cartesian coordinate. That is. We will see the following example. For example, if we want to find the surface area of solid revolution generated by this curve rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, then we use the last formula because the function is explicit, not by using the parametric equation. Because the y is equal to the square root of x, then we have if the y is equal to the curve y is equal to square root of x, yeah, from 0 until 1 is rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have the shape like this. So we want to calculate the surface area of this shape. So it is equal to 2 pi integral from 0 until 1 of the fx. The fx is actually equal to the square of x. And then the square root of 1 plus dy dx square. Because the y is equal to the square root of x, then the dy dx is equal to 1 over 2 square root of x. So we have this expression, and we can easily calculate this in the following page. So the s is actually this one. And by using a very simple calculation, we just use the square, yeah, something like this, yeah. We can move inside. We can move the square root of x inside to the square, so it is become a square root of x square. So square root of x square is equal to x. So this is the x. So the x time 1 plus 1 over 4x dx. So all together is equal to 2 pi integral from 0 to 1, 1 over 2 square root of the 4x plus 1. And then by using a substitution in the definite integral, yeah, by using this substitution, then we have the integral of pi integral from 0 to 5. Why? Because when the x is equal to 1, the u as substitution is equal to 1. When the x is equal to 1, and then the u is equal to 5. So altogether we have this number, the 5 divided by 6 times 5 square 5 minus 1, a square unit. So this is actually the area. So in conclusion, this shape, the area of the surface of this shape is equal to 5 divided by 6 times 5 square root of 5 minus 1. That's all about the two formula. The first is the formula of the surface area of solid revolution in parametric equation, and secondly in explicit function Cartesian coordinate y is equal to fx. Here in the book of Sullivan there are many examples, and there are many exercises. Of course I don't want to go in detail. I just want to show you there are many examples. This is very, very good to do exercise here. Very interesting. And we have here the lecture note, the diktat. It is in Indonesian language. I don't want to go in detail because it is already written in your lecture notes. So I go to the